फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ दीपा सुरेश. वेलकम बैक टू दीप्स किचन. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी चेटिनार चिकन करी, विच इज़ अ वेरी फेमस साउथ इंडियन रेसिपी. द स्पेशलिटी ऑफ चेटिनार कुकिंग इज दे ऑलवेज यूज फ्रेशली ब्लेंड स्पाइसेस इन देयर डिशेस एंड दैट मेक्स इट वेरी अरोमेटिक, डिलीशियस एंड हेल्दी एज वेल. सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड. हियर गोस द इंग्रेडिएंट लिस्ट. We will begin by making chettinad masala paste. For that you will need 1 tablespoon of coriander seeds. I have just crushed them coarsely so that it will get cooked very quicker. 1 tablespoon of cumin seeds, 2 red chilies, 1/4 teaspoon of oil, just a few drops of oil. And now start dry roasting this ingredient for just 30 to 40 seconds. So after 30 to 40 seconds of dry roasting, we have to add rest of the spices. Here I have 2 inch size of cinnamon, 3 cloves, 1 teaspoon of peppercorns, 1 teaspoon of fennel seeds, 1/4 teaspoon of poppy seeds, 2 spings of curry leaf, 2 spings of curry leaf. And now you have to dry roast all these ingredients for another 3 minutes till you get a nice aroma. Make sure that your flame is at low to medium, not high. You don't want any of these ingredients to get burnt. So dry roast them in low to medium flame. So after 3 minutes of dry roasting, now you guys can see this curry leaves and red chili has become crisp, and also other spices have slightly changed in its color. And now I am also getting very nice aroma. At this point of time, add 1/4 cup of freshly grated coconut and just give it a mix. And now switch off the flame and allow it to completely cool down. And once it is cooled down, using your blender or mixer jar, blend them into a very smooth paste, and you could also add some water while blending. Now we have to prepare onion and tomato paste. For that, in a kadai, add 1 tablespoon of oil, 2 onion cut into cubes. You may also use salads, that is a pearl onion. Traditionally they use salads only for making chettinad cooking, but I am using a regular big onion. And 2 tomatoes cut into cubes along with some salt. Just mix them up well, and you have to cook this for 10 more minutes by covering it with a lid. So after 10 minutes, onion and tomatoes are perfectly cooked. They have soft now. So now let this to cool down completely and then blend them to a smooth paste. Keep it ready. And now we will proceed with making chettinad chicken curry. So to make this chettinad chicken curry, now in another kadai, add 3 tablespoons of oil, Once oil is slightly warm, add 1 inch piece of cinnamon, 3 cloves, 2 star anise, 1 cardamom crushed and 2 bay leaf. Just allow them to fry for a couple of seconds, and you don't want them to get burnt, so make sure you have kept the flame at low. And here I have a few Blackstone flour. You can get it at any South Indian stores. They look like a kind of black and white paper which is looking shrinked. So this is the special spice which makes the chettinad cooking really flavorful, and this is a very very important ingredient. So I just add 4 Blackstone flours and followed by 1/2 teaspoon of fennel seeds. So once they splutter, add 1 tablespoon of ginger and 1 tablespoon of garlic paste. I actually forget to shoot it while I added ginger garlic paste, so you have to add ginger garlic paste and cook them till raw flavor goes, and then add your chicken. So I am using 400 grams of chicken. So make sure you have washed your chicken with hot water, salt, and then marinate it with some turmeric for just 10 minutes. And now I'm going to cook the chicken with ginger garlic paste for 2 minutes. And after 2 minutes, add the masala paste which we prepared. So here is the masala paste. Mix it well and cover it with the lid, and you have to cook this chicken with this masala paste for 5 minutes. So cooking your chicken with this freshly blend spices really makes your chicken taste amazing. So this is a very important step. So now I'm going to add a salt to taste. And cover it with the lid and cook for just 5 minutes. And after 5 minutes of cooking, you will get an amazing aroma from this spices. And now add onion and tomato paste into this. Mix it well. And remember, we have added salt to this onion and tomato paste, so no need to add salt now. But if you are going to add some water to dilute it, you have to add some more salt. So I'm going to add around 3/4 cup of water because we have to cook chicken, right? So I added 3/4 cup. So give it a mix once again and check for salt. And now you have to cover it with the lid and cook for around 20 to 25 minutes till your chicken is completely done. So it's been around 30 minutes. Let's see how our chettinad chicken curry looks. Wow! See how nice the color looks, and they are perfectly done. And I'm getting a very nice aroma. I can't wait to try it. So okay, so I actually cooked this curry for 20 minutes. After 20 minutes, the chicken was completely cooked, and later I simmered the flame and cooked for another 10 minutes. This really helps in enhance the flavor of this curry. So my tip here is, once your chicken is completely cooked, reduce the flame to sim and cook for another 10 minutes by covering it with a lid. That really makes this curry more delicious. So our delicious and aromatic chettinad chicken curry is now ready. So I'm going to sprinkle some curry leaves and finely chopped coriander leaves over it to make it more flavorful. and your Chettinad chicken curry is now ready to enjoy. So friends, our delicious and aromatic Chettinad style chicken curry is now ready to enjoy. If you love Chettinad cooking and if you like chicken, this is a very must recipe you should try. And once you try it, I'm sure definitely your taste buds would ask for it again and again. So serve it with some more coriander leaves on its top to make it more appetizing. And you can serve this curry with the hot steamed rice, idli, dosa, uttapam, or even with roti, chapati, paratha or naan. With anything, it tastes amazing. So give this one a try and share your feedback in the comment section. Do share this video with your friends on social networks like Facebook, Google Plus and Twitter so that your friends also would enjoy. Thank you so much for tuning in, and I will catch you guys soon with another interesting video recipe. Till then, enjoy other videos from my channel and spice up your taste buds every day. Bye bye.